the recognized symbol of excellence in sports entertainment.
The World Wrestling Federation always delivers action and excitement, and all of us here at the Hershey Park Arena are proud to be a part of it.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Superstars of Wrestling here at ringside with Vince McMahon, along with wrestling's living legend, Bruno Sammartino, and of course, joining us as always, Jesse the Body Ventura. And this week, do we ever have events for you? Unfortunately, however, due to an edict from World Wrestling Federation President Jack Sonny, we are prohibited from publicly speaking of the events of just last night. But nonetheless, we will have...
What are you talking about?
You read the memo just like I did. Any official in the World Wrestling Federation, be they announcers, wrestlers, or referees of any kind, are prohibited at this moment of speaking of the events of last night. Nonetheless, I'm sure we'll have all kinds of World Wrestling Federation action. Let's get underway.
Approaching the ring area, led by his manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan, from Robbinsdale, Minnesota, weighing 251 pounds, Ravishing Rick Rude!
Ravishing Rick Rude on the way to the squared circle. Listen to that music. Jesse, you should be bumping and grinding to that.
Well, I'll tell you what. There he is right there, the winner of the Jesse the Body Award. First annual, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Cut that music.
What?
Cut the music.
Wow.
What I'd like to have right now...
Listen
is
to the
for
boom.
All you overweight Hershey-fed heifers to keep down the noise while I take my robe off and show the ladies the true meaning of simply ravishing. Hit the music!
What does he mean by that?
Listen, do you hear all the overweight heifers booing?
No, I don't. That's not one there.
Look at this. That's disgusting.
Disgusting?
Yeah.
I mean, can the guy wrestle or not? I mean, that's why he's here.
At least I think that's why he's here.
And his opponent...
All right, you can, in just a moment,
from Hawaii,
you can expect pandemonium.
Weighing 237 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
There's a look at the Dragon. And the Dragon, no doubt, with a breathing fire here, locking up the Ravishing Rick Rude. No love lost between these two.
Well, the Dragon better breathe fire because... I don't think he's ever stepped into the ring with a man with a better body than Ravishing Rick Rude.
Listen, he and Rude have had a go or two in the past. The Dragon knows everything I believe there is to know about Ravishing Rick Rude.
Ravishing Rick Rude better not worry too much about his ravishing body and concentrate on Steamboat because he's going to have his hands full.
Well, one thing's for sure, you never had to worry about a ravishing body when you wrestled, Bruno.
Yeah, Rick Rude would love to be able to, after it's all over, say he has a record anywhere near comparable to that of Bruno Sammartino.
Hey, when Bruno wrestled, it was all them old-timers. None of them old athletes can beat the athletes of today.
Is that right?
Yeah, take a look at any world record. Why do you think they get broken?
Rick Rude attempting to establish a superiority.
Rude is the classic example of modern training techniques. Proper diet, vitamins, weight training along with wrestling.
Locking back up, standing side headlock, grinding it out here on the dragon a bit. Ravishing Rick Rude in control. And a very nice maneuver. Oh, wait a minute, what's this? What is going on here? Hercules and the King down at ringside? Why?
Moral support.
Moral support?
They're a family.
Rick Rude over the dragon. Off the rope again. Leapfrog by the dragon. Tremendous agility. And off and... what's this? To the rope again. Over. Right back now. It's the dragon. Going underneath and... One, two, and... no, not quite. Arm drag takes down the dragon. And another one. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat in control.
Well, the one thing the dragon does well, he gets in deep on that arm drag. He gets well underneath and forces the man. The man has to go over the top or lose a shoulder or arm.
This capacity crowd chanting almost in unison, Weasel. Look at that. Whoa. Leg trip, nice maneuver, elbow follow through. The dragon all over ravishing Rick Rude. And if this continues, Mr. Rude's physique may not be so ravishing after the match.
Well, Steamboat's doing a smart move here. He's trying to take away something on Rude, and he's trying to take the arm away from him.
He's also not being affected by what Heenan's trying to do by bringing those two to the ringside. The King and Hercules is to intimidate Steamboat, but he's paying no attention. He's doing his job in the ring, and look at him go.
Yes, look at that. Missing with a right hand, and another arm drag takedown. So the psychology thus far employed by Bobby the Brain Heenan is not working. Indeed, the presence of the King and Hercules Hernandez apparently has no effect on the performance of the dragon. Uh-oh, look at this. Oh, my.
Yes, but Rick Rude might have an effect on the performance of the dragon.
Oh, my, is he ever right now. Rick Rude hammering away on Ricky Steamboat, scoops him up now. And slams him down to the canvas with authority. Following through with a forearm, I believe, to the throat area. Only a count of one.
That's two count. We have got the three, idiot.
Bobby Heenan wanting a little faster count as the dragon whipped off the ropes. Puts the brakes on.
Well, he caught Rude there. Rude made a mistake. He dropped his head. Didn't watch the dragon. He allowed the dragon to slip into that neck breaker real quick off the ropes.
Both men back to their feet. Roundhouse misses. Elbow to the mitt. Look at that. Yes, indeed.
And I think Rude wants time out here. He's backing off.
Rick Rude. Two, my. His face may never be the same. The body might be all right, but the head will suffer.
There's only one wrestler I know who would enjoy that move, George the Animal Steel.
The dragon on the top rope. Rude stunned. He spins around. Right across the top. Wait a minute. Hercules is on the apron. Get him down from there. The dragon with another chop. Harley Race grabbing the ankle of Ricky Steamboat as the referee's back was turned.
Throwing him into the ring. That's an automatic disqualification. You know what I'll bet? I'll bet Steamboat planned this out, that if he got in trouble, he wanted the Ultimate Warrior to get out here.
It wasn't Steamboat in trouble. It was ravishing Rick Rude in a lot of trouble. And right now, pandemonium is breaking loose. Oh, my, the Ultimate Warrior down to the canvas. Come on, Ralph, get control here. Jim Duggan! Hacksaw Jim Duggan!
makes Ben run from the ring.
No, it's not his presence. It's that board he's carrying.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the referee's official decision. As a result of outside interference, he has ruled this contest a double disqualification.
A what?
Wow. A double disqualification. Now, how in the world can a referee make that kind of decision when it was the Ultimate Warrior that threw Race into the ring?
But it was Race who tripped Steamboat. Or did you see that,
the
Jesse?
Referee didn't see it.
Let's go back now and pick up the replay.
Now, look at this very clearly. Look at Race. And here he is tripping up Steamboat.
Yeah, and the ref didn't see it.
Hey, regardless, he did do it. Already, what are you talking about? Hernandez was already in the ring.
And take a look at that. Hacksaw Jim Duggan on the way to the ring. And the Hacksaw sends Ben scurrying, headed for cover, the whole Heenan family. Here now, ladies and gentlemen, Craig DeGeorge with a special update on WrestleMania 4.